After the diesel fuel, the next one is hydraulic. Sorry, next one is electric shovel. The shovel under this category are used widely in Indian mines and are manufactured by Heavy Engineering Corporation, which is located in Ranchi. The most popular model of them is excavator EQC 4.6. The picture is shown. Is the figure is shown here, that is EQC 4.6. It has 12 parts. Number 1, that is dipper. Number 2 is handle. Number 3 is crowd mechanism. Number 4 is boom. Number 5 is dipper opening mechanism. Number 6 is track frame. Number 7 is turntable. Number 8 is roller circle. Number 9 is crawler mechanism. Number 10 is boom west winch. Number 11 is west winch, and the number 12 is a frame. So this is the picture of excavator EQC 4.6. This electrical shovel consists of the following mechanism. Number 1 is motor generator set, crowd mechanism, hoist mechanism, swing mechanism, travel mechanism, pneumatic control system, and undercarriage unit. So let's start with the deck layout. The figure shows the deck layout of the electrical shovel. The principle of equipment of power is a motor generator set, that is MG set, which is usually placed at the rear side of the machine. And motor generator set consists of an AC induction motor, swing generator, voice generator, crowd generator, and exciter. There is a common shaft connecting this, that is motor generator, that is sorry, there is a common shaft connecting that this, that is motor generator and exciter. All AC motor is energized by taking power from the HT line, which finally drive all the generator. All the generators are DC generator. The crowd generator supply power to the crowd motor, the host generator to the host motor. The swing generator supply power to the swing and propel motor alternatively. This is when supplying to the swing motor and propellant motor is cut off and vice versa. So this is the deck layout of the electrical shovel. Next is crowd mechanism. The figure shown the crowd mechanism. It consists of crowd motor, which is number one, then which deliver power through the pinion to the overload clutch. Then overload clutch deliver power to a pinion, which is in consistence with the gear. The gear drives two crowd pinion on both its side, which finally reciprocate the dipper stick with the help of a rack rigidly fixed in the underside of the dipper stick. Braking of the motor is done by means of the drum attached to the motor shaft. After the crowd mechanism, the next is hoist mechanism. The hoisting of the boom and the bucket of the shovel is performed by the mechanism, which is shown in this figure. One end of the motor shaft is connected to the reducer through a coupling. The reducer delivers power is constant means with the hoist gear. This provided movement of the hoist drum, which lifts the bucket. The other end of the motor shaft is connected to a worm wheel through a chain sprocket system. The boom hoist drum is mounted on the output shaft of the worm wheel combination. This the boom hoist is rotated. Then the next one is, after the hoist mechanism, the next mechanism is swing mechanism. Here is the picture of the swing mechanism. The swing mechanism consists of two units. It has a vertical motor with its flange resting on the housing. At the end of the vertical motor shaft, there is a pinion in mesh with the gear. There is a common shaft in the reducer over which both the pinion and the gear are mounted. Hence, power from the gear is transmitted to the pinion, which is again in mesh with another gear. This gear carries a vertical shaft, that is the output shaft of the reducer at the end of the switch's pinion. This is known as swing pinion, which is in mesh with the bull gear of the equipment. After the swing mechanism, next one is travel mechanism. The travel mechanism is driven by a motor cylindrical cum bevel reducer, which is shown in the figure. The reducer is connected to the motor by flexible coupling. The design of the reducer shown in the picture. The bevel pinion receives power from the motor through the coupling, and the bevel gear is in mesh with the pinion. Ultimately, power from the reducer through a gearing arrangement is given to the right hand side and the left hand side door clutch. These door clutches are disengaging by a separate hydraulic system. Power from the door clutches phases through another reducer to arrive the driving wheel of a crawler mechanism which propels the whole equipment. After the travel mechanism, next is a hydraulic system, hydraulic control. Hydraulic control for door clutch. This is designed to control the propel mechanism, brake and clutch shift mechanism of the cat bell. The picture is shown. An electrical motor is connected through a coupling with the gear pump. Oil is sucked from the tank, forced through the reliever into pressure line to propel the brake cylinder through an electromagnetic valve to the cylinder of the clutch shaft mechanism to the cat valve. The relief valve prevents the pressure in the hydraulic system from rising above the rated value. Oil flow through the drain hole directly to the tank. The braking action of the driving sprocket is achieved by means of a brake cylinder operated by a hydraulic mechanism. So, after the hydraulic mechanism, next is the pneumatic control system. So, just a minute. Here is the picture of hydraulic control. Just a minute. Yeah. This is the pneumatic control system for the hydraulic control. This pneumatic system consists of twin cylinder reciprocating compressor driven by an AC motor and deliver air to the tank through air check valve. The tank is fitted with a pressure gauge and a safety valve. Air from the tank is distributed to the swing mechanism brake cylinder, which are controlled through three separately operated solenoid valves. There is one siren operated by air through another solenoid valve. The remaining end is connected to a T-valve for any other auxiliary use. Here the delivery pressure of the compressor is 7.0 kg per square centimeter and the safety valve pressure is 7.5 kg per square centimeter. After this
pneumatic control system. The last one of the last one is undercut genuine in the front attachment of the electric shovel, where they perform the same function of diesel shovel. The construct are also similar to the diesel shovel. So the only changes are the shape of the driving sprocket of the crawler unit. Instead of the driving sprocket, it has a cam wheel which are in constant connection with the cad wheel. An endless chain is sprocket and is supported by a number of wheel mounted on the main frame. After the completing the electric shovel,
the next is hydraulic shovel.
After electrical shovel, let's come to the hydraulic shovel. The implementation of this concept started as early as 1950. As many as 36 versions are available throughout the world nowadays. A undercarriage unit are very similar to those of other shovel, but the superstructure and the front attachment are different from this earlier shovel. In the picture, the general view of the shovel is shown. This hydraulic shovel is consists of one prime mover, one is prime mover, number two superstructure and at this attachment, number three is hydraulic mechanism, and the number four is undercarriage unit. So let's start with the prime mover. Both diesel engine and electric motor are used as a prime mover. Details of electric or diesel engine are mentioned earlier in either the electric motor. AC induction motor are usually preferred in the present case. So then next is hydraulic mechanism. The hydraulic mechanism is added by a hydraulic circuit. The picture is here. The picture shown about the hydraulic circuit. The hydraulic circuit for a hydraulic excavator. The fluid is pumped by four pumps directly coupled with the prime mover. The pump have the following duty. Number one, one pump is for attachment. Number two, the second pump is for swing motor operation. And number three, the third and the fourth pumps are for the traction motor. In addition to this, this circuit contain two valve bank, that is valve bank 1 and valve 2, and one modulator, two boom cylinder. It also contain two traction motor swing and a swing motor. Next is valve bank number 1. This unit receives pressurized fluid from the pump and distributes it according to the operator's control to the front attachment, that is for boom, stick and bucket operation. Valve bank are nothing but a series of spool valve placed in a single unit and are controlled from a operator scale. The spool of the valve are controlled by hydraulic means. Next is valve bank number 2. Receiving of fluid and its control are the same as that in the bank number 1, but the delivery line of these are attached to the swing and traction motor. The next is modulator. This is an assembly which makes and breaks the flow to the circuit according to the system depends. The present modulator is a two-stage low regulation device which enables the system to receive a higher flow in low pressure and can subsequently cut the rate of flow to negotiate high developed pressure. Two of these pump flow pass through the modulator. When the system reaches 220 bar, one of this pump flow is redirected back to the source. Similarly, when the pump pressure reaches 290 bar, another pump is regulated.